Hello everyone, welcome to the class. Today we will be talking about indirect tagging and mixed tagging status monitoring drugs. So let us look at the contents. This drugs we'll be discussing today is amphetamine, tyramine, and ephedrine. So let us have a look. Here what we can see is that the catecholamines and the sympathomimetic drugs, they are classified as either as directly acting drugs or as indirectly acting drugs or as mixed acting drugs. The drugs that are directly acting, they act via different adrenergic receptors. We have already discussed about different adrenergic receptors, alpha receptors and the beta receptors, right? So the drugs that act at the receptor level directly, they are called directly acting drugs. The drugs that act by increasing the release of the neurotransmitters, they are called directly acting drugs. And mixed acting drugs are those drugs that directly act at the receptor level and also indirectly they cause the release of the neurotransmitters. They are called mixed acting sympathomimetics. Here we can have a look at the examples. The directly acting drugs are epinephrine, norepinephrine, isoprenaline, dopamine, dobutamine, clonidine, clavitalin. These are all the examples of directly acting drugs. Whereas for indirectly acting drugs, amphetamine and tyramine are typical examples, and mixed acting drugs is ephedrine. So, how many of you can guess as to which book is this slide taken from? I guess most of you came up with a correct guess, right? This is taken from Goodman and Gilman. You can see that adrenergic agonist drugs, they are classified into directly acting, mixed acting, and indirectly acting drugs. And further, indirectly acting drugs, they are divided into selective and non-selective drugs. When we say selective drugs, they go for selective action on alpha 1, alpha 2, beta 1, or beta 2 adrenal receptors. When they are non-selective, they might act either on alpha non-selectively, both alpha 1 and alpha 2, or on beta non-selectively, like the case of isoproterenol, where it acts on both of beta 1 and beta 2, or it may be acting on alpha and beta both the receptors, like the case of epinephrine and norepinephrine. The case of mixed acting drug is, the example of mixed acting drug is ephedrine, which acts on alpha 1, alpha 2, beta 1, beta 2, and also acts by releasing the neurotransmitters. Then when it comes to indirectly acting drugs, there are three different kinds again. The releasing agents, the uptake inhibitor, and the MAO or COMT inhibitors. Today we'll be focusing on basically the releasing agents. And releasing agents of indirectly acting drugs and then the mixed acting drugs. Okay, so moving on to amphetamine. Amphetamine is often called the Superman drug, and this is a phenyl isopropyl amine that is important simply because of its use as a CNS stimulant. And because it is very much used as a CNS stimulant, we call it a Superman drug as well. Its pharmacokinetics is very much similar to that of ephedrine. However, amphetamine enters the CNS much more rapidly as compared to ephedrine. It has got marked stimulant effect on the mood and alertness and depression effect on the appetite. Its peripheral actions are mediated primarily through the release of catecholamines. Methamphetamine or N-methylamphetamine is very similar to amphetamine and has even higher ratio of central to peripheral actions. Let us look at the mechanism of action. As I said earlier, amphetamine is an indirectly acting sympathomimetic drug, right? So it promotes the release of stored norepinephrine. This does not require action potential or exocytosis, which would normally be required for the release of norepinephrine. Because we are giving amphetamine here, it spontaneously causes the release of stored norepinephrine. This releases norepinephrine, it enters the synaptic cleft by reuptake 1 by reverse transport. Hence, the effect of indigenously released norepinephrine is potentiated. The effects of amphetamine is CNS effects are very much pronounced, right? It has got marked stimulant effect on CNS. So there is wakefulness and alertness. There is increased sense of fatigue. It elevates the mood and produces euphoria. Okay. There is an increased initiative, self-confidence, and ability to concentrate. It has got a depressant effect on appetite as well, and it increases the physical performance in athletes. Therefore, it is one of the most abused drugs as well. The peripheral actions also happen as a result of amphetamine, and this is due to the release of catecholamines. It is a highly abused drug. due to euphoria and also effects, some amphetamine variants have got high abuse potential. Now, coming on to the next drug, tyramine. Tyramine is a normal byproduct of tyrosine metabolism in the body, and it is found in high concentration in fermented foods such as cheese and wine. It is readily metabolized by MAO in the liver or monoamine oxidase in the liver, and is normally inactive when taken orally. And this is because of the high first pass effect that has got very, very low bioavailability. But however, when this drug is administered parenterally, it has got an indirect sympathomimetic action, which causes a release of stored catecholamines. Consequently, its spectrum of action is similar to that of norepinephrine. So you can have a look at this picture that's given slide. Tyramine is formed from the action on L-amino acid, decarboxylase on tyrosine. Tyramine gets converted into octopamine and finally into norepinephrine and epinephrine. This picture is taken from Kaplan pharmacology. In patients who are treated with MAO inhibitors, particularly the inhibitors of MAO, MAO as a form like oclobemide, which is an antidepressant drug, the effect of tyramine will be greatly intensified and it leads to markedly increase in blood pressure. This occurs on account of increased bioavailability of tyramine and increased neuronal stores of catecholamines. Patients who are taking MAO inhibitors must be very careful to avoid tyramine containing foods. The tyramine reaction or cheese reaction may occur. So let us look, what is tyramine reaction or cheese reaction? The cheese reaction is simply the potentiation of the cardiovascular effects of tyramine or other indirectly acting sympathomimetic amines by irreversible inhibitors of MAO. The foods that are reputed to have high content of tyramine are other sympathomimetic agents. Let's have a look. Beer has tyramine content 4 to 45 mg in an average serving. Then broad beans and fava beans, they are negligible, but they contain dopamine. And again, cheese, natural or agent, they both contain 0 to 130 mg per serving. Then chicken liver, similarly chocolate, sauces, smoked fish, snails, wine, yeast, they all are known to contain high levels of tyramine and therefore should be avoided with monoamine oxidase inhibitors. Okay, now moving on to ephedrine. Ephedrine is the first orally active next acting sympathomimetic drug. Its source is ephedra plant. The pharmacokinetics, it shows that high oral bioavailability and it is known to cross the blood-brain barrier. It has got long duration of action of around 3 to 4 hours. It's eliminated in the urine largely as an unchanged drug, and being a meat base, its excretion can be enhanced by the acidification of urine. Okay, now coming to the mechanism of action of ephedrine. We said earlier that it is a mixed acting sympathomimetic drug, right? So it has got direct agonist action on both alpha and beta receptors, and also it acts directly by promoting the release of stored norepinephrine from adrenergic neurons. Hence, the effect of endogenously released norepinephrine is potentiated. Its pharmacologic effects include stimulates heart rate and cardiac output, increases peripheral vascular resistance, elevates the blood pressure, produces bronchodilation, and it is a potent CNS stimulant. Its therapeutic uses of ephedrine can be seen in case of chronic orthostatic hypotension due to autonomic failure, the drug of choice being midodrine, in case of acute hypotensive states associated with spinal anesthesia, as a bronchodilator in bronchial asthma or obstructive pulmonary disease, and in case of myasthenia gravis in conjunction with anticholinergic stress. Yeah. Thank you. That is all for today.